We want you to consider how playing everyday games like soccer, spinning tops, or even jumping rope might be affected by a lack of gravity, and what adjustments are needed as a result. Here are some ways that you can test out your guesses and try this at home.
I'm Ninette, and I want to know how playing soccer in space is different than on Earth. The rules of the games are you can kick the ball off your feet or bounce it off your head, but you can't use your hands to pass the ball. How does playing soccer change when played in space? In space, there is no gravity to hold the soccer player's feet to the ground. This makes it much harder to kick the ball with force in any direction since there is no surface to push against with your legs. So crew members must use their arms to help position their bodies in order to execute their move.
I'm Chloe, and I want to know how a spinning top operates in space. First, let's see how it works on Earth. To spin a top into motion, force must be applied in order to convert it from potential stored energy to kinetic moving energy. The momentum from the applied force keeps it spinning on an invisible axis until the top is slowed by friction from the table surface. Torque produced by gravity from the atmosphere makes it unstable, slowing it to a stop. Now let's see how it works in space. On the shuttle, the spinning top floats in microgravity. Because the top does not rotate on a surface, there is reduced friction. This allows the top to spin longer, with more stability.
Did you guess correctly on how the objects would behave in space? What things would you like to see in microgravity? Let us know in the comments section. And if you like this video, be sure to follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.